Chatbots are becoming ubiquitous in our lives. What role do you see chatbots playing in healthcare?
Fundamentally, there aren't enough professionals, people to be able to meet the demands of healthcare today. Whether that's looking at the billion questions that are getting asked on Google related to health every single day, those questions don't have enough humans to be able to answer a patient who, say, has just been diagnosed with a condition and is turning to Google to try to find out more information about, say, a product they're prescribed for their doctor or different medical information that healthcare professional is looking for to find what's the best resource to treat their patient. This is where conversational AI can be used to scale and reach patients, doctors, nurses, pharmacists to be able to answer their questions in an ongoing fashion that's really able to provide better healthcare outcomes.
So where do you see the biggest opportunities to use chatbots in the healthcare industry?
So we really have been seeing a lot of use cases in the pharmaceutical industry. And part of the reason why we've been so focused on this is because the problems that we see patients and doctors and various healthcare professionals facing on a daily basis, trying to simply ask for information versus needing to search it or go through all these high friction channels, is also aligns really perfectly with the business benefits that you see in the pharmaceutical industry, where they're struggling to be able to provide this information at that moment of need, whether it's about the indications for a drug and what it can be used for, or different medical information that's being made available, and that changes on a very frequent basis with the different educational materials coming out. This is where chatbots, voice, and conversational AI really have the ability to remove that friction to all of these resources that exist today and allow people to simply ask instead of search.
People have a tendency to overshare when they're using chatbots. How do you ensure the chatbot doesn't use information it should?
What's the first thing you do when you get, say, diagnosed with a condition, or if you think that you are maybe coming down with a fever? You go onto Google and type out all of your personal health information.
You find out all of the things and you give them all of your information.
Exactly. And I think that that's where one of the strengths of chatbots as a technology is that it really can provide that non-judgmental emotional support as well as clinical support to patients whenever they are at that moment of need. And then it's the responsibility of technology companies to be able to make sure that you're treating that personal health information appropriately and, say, in our case, scraping anything that is that personal identifiable information to really find what's the core reason that you're coming to the bot looking for resources and providing you with that support on demand.
What kind of cost savings and efficiencies does the average client realize?
So ultimately, the goal in a lot of these conversational AI applications is to be able to reduce the friction of this information, extend the reach, but also decrease the cost per interaction. Today, these all exist. I mean, ultimately, when, let's say, a consumer, a patient, or a healthcare professional has a question of a pharmaceutical company, either they're waiting for a person to be there at that moment of need, or they're calling a call center between the hours of 9 to 5, Monday through Friday. Typically, it's costing between $150 to $250 per session or per question, essentially, that somebody would have for pharma in those cases. So that's where the bots are, you know, a fraction of the cost and really scalable, so that you're not just answering that question, you're taking the best answer to that question and scaling that one out to the masses.
So what's next for Conversation Health? What are your expansion plans?
Ultimately, the power of conversations in healthcare really can push better outcomes, whether that's a conversation between a doctor and a patient at that moment of diagnosis, where it's a highly emotional time, and let's say you're lucky to ask 10 questions to your doctor in that room. You're lucky to remember the answer correctly to one of those questions because it's such that emotional time. This is where we have the ability to move from this episodic relationship with our health, seeing your doctor once every 6 months, to a continuous one using the power of conversational AI. What I'm really excited for is this ability to even move it past that to highly personalized support based off of who you are, what kind of support you need, whether it's more emotional in nature, whether it's more clinical, whether it's high touch or low touch. You really have the power to be able to provide that personal digital nurse in your pocket that's truly supportive for you on that journey and have better health outcomes.
We're in Silicon Valley. Why is it important for you to have a presence here?
Well, I mean, ultimately, I think one of the big importances of being in the Valley is having this amazing connection to resources as well as technical partners that can really help you move to that next scale of impact within your business. We're really lucky that in Canada, two of the three grandfathers of AI are there. So there's amazing talent specifically within the AI space that we've been able to leverage out of the University of Toronto and the network around there. But coming down to the Valley, you can just see the energy and the additional research that's being done in this space.